dear friends, I hope that you're doing well and welcome back to Plants and Lucia. My name is Lucia and today we talk about perlite and vermiculite, what they are and what we use them for. Okay, coming up! Whether you are coming back or this is your first time in this channel, thank you so much for being with me and watching this video. I am a plant beginner and I learn about my houseplants every day. So this channel is to share with you what I learned. So if you want to learn how to take care of your houseplants, how to display them, or even how to connect with them, make sure to subscribe so we can see each other every week and talk about plants. But now, let's get to the video. So when we talk about perlite and vermiculite, the biggest misconception is that you can interchange them. Yes, they are both expanded volcanic rocks, but they have many differences. One is very porous, the other one is not. One absorbs water, the other one doesn't. One aerates the soil, the other one does not. So what I thought is that maybe we can look at each one of them, what they are, and really what we use them for. So let's start with perlite. Perlite is the most commonly used expanded volcanic rock in gardening. It is very loose and light, aerates the soil so the roots can actually go easily through it, and provides a lot of drainage. So let's talk about two very good ways that you can use perlite with your plant. Number one, prevents caking. So caking is something that happens with our potting mix as it dries out and it gets wet, and it dries out and it gets wet, and again and again. So as our potting mix continues to dry out and get wet, it starts to compress and compact. And this is not good because then when we water our plants, the water tends to go around the soil like this and then along the edges of the pot. So it doesn't get to the roots. So with perlite, we prevent the soil from caking and allows a more fluffy structure. That way the roots can actually move through the soil and the water actually can go through the soil and get to the roots. The second use for perlite is that it provides great drainage. You can use perlite in many sizes. So you have extra fine, fine, medium, coarse, and extra coarse. So for example, you can add medium perlite to your potting mix to add drainage in the soil. You can also use an extra coarse perlite to put at the bottom of the pot, and this also helps with drainage. This can be used instead of rocks, and it's great because it provides drainage at the bottom of the pot and it is way lighter than rocks. So yes, I personally use perlite in my potting mix to add drainage. My recipe includes 2 parts of medium-sized perlite, 2 parts of worm castings, and 7 parts of coconut coir. I love using perlite because I know that I'm providing drainage to my plants in the potting mix. Of course, you can also use pumice instead of perlite. Okay, on to vermiculite. Vermiculite, which is right here, is actually a lesser known expanded volcanic rock, but it's also very useful. It absorbs moisture very well. That's a very big difference between vermiculite and perlite. Perlite does not absorb moisture, but vermiculite is very absorbent. And it is super light, you guys. So let's see what are some very good uses for vermiculite. Vermiculite is very useful when starting seeds. This is because of two reasons. First, as I said, vermiculite is very absorbent. And as you may know, seeds love moisture. So if you add vermiculite to your seed starter mix, this is gonna be great for your seeds, as they will have the water that they need. The second reason is that vermiculite is very light. So this is perfect when germinating seeds. Because it is so light, the seed will be able to push through the vermiculite when you put it on the top. So vermiculite will protect your seeds, prevent caking in a seed starter mix, provide the moisture that your seeds need, and will be very light so the germinating seeds can actually push through. So there you have it. These are some of the main differences between perlite and vermiculite. Do you have any other questions about these two? Do you have other uses for them? Please make sure to comment below so we can all learn together. Of course, if you would like to be part of this community, you're always welcome. So make sure to subscribe so we can see each other every week and talk about plants. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Okay, ciao!